much. Vincent, take it away.
Right back there, you'll see dozens and dozens of model trams.
that were made by the kids of Roosevelt Island, from CDM, from the Parents Network, from Island Kids, from PS217, from the Explorers, also some from our seniors, and from other people who found out about our boxes, took a box, decorated it. They're absolutely wonderful, and I suggest you see them in the kiosk afterwards. I also want to thank Lynn Shinazaki, the human whirlwind of Roosevelt Island. She did the Cherry Blossom Festival 2 weeks ago, so we gave her a few days off to do this with us. And Lynn is amazing.
She's over there, Judy.
Oh, there she is. Oh, that's her husband, Michael, who tries to keep her under control. And I also want to thank Chris Needy's at Riverwalk for the refreshments we're going to have afterwards. Wait till you see the cake. Way back in 1972, an architect of this soon-to-be community discovered that the MTA subway would not be completed in time and ready for people to start riding it. An alternate mode of transportation had to be developed. The name was Bill Chaffee. He's no longer with us, but he was a ski enthusiast, and he thought of a ski lift, a tram, like in ski resorts. Well, they went out and searched all the different blocks in Manhattan where they could possibly put a cable car. And the only one that they thought was semi-feasible was 72nd Street because it was a double wide street. But luckily, they soon discovered that there was a big vacant lot at 59th Street and 2nd Avenue because the city always said they were going to improve access to the Queensboro Bridge. Well, we got the lot, and soon the tram project was underway. The tram was then called an aerial gondola. Sounds very romantic. And the tram opened in 76, and as many of you know who've lived here for more than a few years, it was the scene of Nighthawks, Fear Factor, City Slickers, Turk 183, Spider-Man 1, and many, many, many other movies and TV shows. The one I thought was the weirdest was Fear Factor, where people climbed in nets under the tram. The first tram system was counterbalance, which meant when one tram left Manhattan, the other tram left the island. It worked okay, but the trouble is if you had to repair something, you had to close down both cabins, and it was a real hassle because they would have to operate with schedule interruptions almost weekly. Roosevelt Island had many fights to save the tram. We had an insurance fight 1 year. We had other discussions. And sometimes people would come to run the island and say, we want to cut the hours. And one person that never let the tram service be interrupted or disturbed was Al Weinstein. Many of you remember him. Yeah. If you look back there, there's a beautiful cherry tree with a plaque next to it with his name. Al would get up in meetings, and he would have speeches written on the back of an envelope and start his speeches with, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. And then he would tell us, you're not going to damage tram or tram service. And he won. Luckily, in 2003, Matt Katz and other members of RERA finally got us on the MetroCard system. And immediately going on the MetroCard system, our ridership increased. November of in the year 2010, the tram finally got a body lift, not only a facelift. It was rebuilt after a minor incident back in 2006, and we finally got a new tram November 30th, 2010. Not only did we get a new tram, new system, independent operation, in the meantime, we had our beautiful visitor center restored that summer. And anyone who thinks it's easy to replace a tram, a 35-year-old tram, should have been here that summer watching the work that went on. It was an absolute miracle, and it got done, I don't know about on budget, but definitely on time. And our tram, as you know, is a symbol of the island known all over the world. The tram is people, the professionals who daily climb up to the towers at 5 a.m. in the morning, the cabin attendants who drive the cabins and deal with every kind of person packed into the cabins, thankfully some of them for only 4 minutes at a time. The tram is Roosevelt Island. No matter who came with the message to cut or shorten the service, it never happened. The tram is here. It is curiously romantic at all hours, day or night. It's the sign of marriage proposals, engagement, and even a wedding. Would you please raise your hand, our bride and groom? Where are you? Wes? They got married here. And we're just sitting in the visitor center one day, and in walked the bride and groom, complete with a bridal gown. So we also had a proposal here a few months ago on a Sunday morning. 100 people are standing here, and a young couple walked off, and she had a ring on her finger. So the tram is available for engagements at any time. The tram brings the world to us, dozens at a time. In 2007, the Historical Society, since 2007, the Historical Society has welcomed thousands to the kiosk from every state, country, continent in the world. The tram is the attraction. Every week, Manhattanites tell us they are here just out of curiosity. Some come into the kiosk, walk up Main Street, many become enamored, and some of them have even moved to the island. The Historical Society site is the scene for tours, for educational programs, and for great shopping. Our staff compliments the tram and makes every visitor feel welcome. The history of Roosevelt Island emerges from the people who ride the tram and tell us their stories, their families, and the who and why of the community. The secret is out, the tram is it. It's loyal staff, riders, making part of our being. I want to introduce to you some of the originators, these young guys who came to work for the New York State Urban Development Corporation back in 1968-69 under Governor Nelson Rockefeller and UDC President Ed Loeb. Ed Loeb was a master builder, and I mean a master builder. He built 20,000 units of affordable housing in the state of New York in the late 1960s when Governor Rockefeller was our governor. Many projects. Ted Lieben, where are you? Where's Ted? There he is. Ted was the chief architect. Jerry Maltz, next to him with the blue hat and beard. Logie Chan, Prentice Olhausen Chan. When you go up to the kiosk, you'll see the original sign with them and some of the names on it. Ralph Olhausen. I want to introduce Jeff Escobar, the president of RERA, the Roosevelt Island Residents Association. Jeff, right here. Okay, we'll come back to Jeff. I also want to have Armando Cordova, our tram manager, give a few words of greeting. Armando, ¿dónde estás? Armando, here he is.
Hey.
Staff, because without the tram staff, many of whom have been here decades, we will not operate. I don't know who's here today. Is Robert Kelly here today? John Vosselman. John, come on down. Come on, John. John has climbed those ropes until his knees are giving out. John is great with the forklift. You can imagine what this man can do with a forklift.
Yeah.
Just no need. Mark Long? Mark, are we? Yes, one shot. Mark is here on the weekends especially, and he always gets those afternoons of thousands of tourists as he's grimacing through them. Is Barry here? Barry? Emilce? She's in Manhattan. David Dierley?
She's in the cabin.
Maria, Joe? Joe is up on the tower. Annie? And where is Greg? Greg?
Just sit down. One more for us in the back, okay?
Okay,
here we go with the good camera. There we go.
Thank you.
He has met more tramps than anyone we know on this island, especially early in the morning. Now from 6:30 to 11:30 every morning, he meets the tram, he takes you to the tram, he takes you to the subway. But being a shy introvert, Carl refused to come. But we have a certificate for Carl, who drives our bus, because Carl has been here over 30 years. And Carl Bradford, so when you see him on the bus, yell at him for not coming today. But we have a certificate for Carl. There are many, many, many employees of this island who serve us and don't get recognized by the community. And I want to give them all a round of applause. Here.
congratulate everyone on their work and continue to offer our support. Thank you.
Where was Ben? There are the city council person, Ben Kalos. You waved beautifully from the tram.
I just want to thank Judy Birdie, who really gives Roosevelt Island a sense of history, it's a sense of time and place, and for putting this great event together. Can we give her a quick round of applause?
Yay!
It is such a pleasure to represent Roosevelt Island and to have an island that is an icon of New York City, is a place that is on everyone's must-visit list. And getting to come here every day with the residents and so very many tourists who are here just to ride the tram, and as long as they're riding the tram, to take a trip down to Four Freedoms, and hopefully we can get them to take a trip further up onto the island and spend some money with our local businesses. But we're so lucky for this to be the place to be. I'll just share one funny story that I had with the tram. This is a new tram. It's a strong tram. It is a tram that they use in other places all over the world. And I was invited to do an event, and sometimes natural disasters get in the way, like Hurricane Sandy. And I was going to be visiting Lynn Strong Shinazaki. She was doing that house party, and I said, is the event canceled? She's like, not at all, we're gonna throw a party. And the tram was the last mode of public transportation to come offline for Sandy, and the first one back online, which makes it more reliable than anything else we've got in the city. We're so lucky to have the tram, and happy to be celebrating this 40 years. We hope to be bringing a proclamation for you, and thank you so very much. We've already had 26 million people into the next 26 million tram riders. Thank you and enjoy.
going to play the Victor's March.
Special, and I will invite you all to come in the kiosk. We have
have some special things today. We have tram magnets. $5. And we have special commemorative limited edition tram mugs. White and red, red and white. And they're available in the kiosk. They're a limited edition. So you have to remember, the kiosk is part of us, part of our community, not just for tourists. And the Roosevelt Island Historical Society depends on you, your family, your friends, and your wallet to keep us running. I want to thank you. I want to invite all the old-timers, Ted, Jerry, everyone, back for a group photograph. And I thank everyone again for coming, and we'll form a perfectly orderly line by the cake. Thank you. Yes? Sorry, Jeff is not here to bring greetings, but Sherry Helstein will give a quick word of greetings from RERA.
Hi, I just wanted to welcome everybody and thank Judy for her hard work and Lynn for her hard work making this event possible. And